Hi Swifties, good morning. Welcome back to my channel. If you've never been here before, my name is Zach. I'm the Taylor Swiftologist. I'm a journalist by day and a Swiftie by choice. And here on this channel, I like to use my journalistic skills to dissect Taylor Swift's public persona. So if that sounds good to you, subscribe, ring the bell, like this video, and leave a comment. Okay, so I am very tired because I was editing until the wee hours of the morning and I just posted my red reaction. So I'm looking a little busted. All I've done is like brush my teeth and put on chapstick before I got back into this video. So I'm going to be reacting to All Too Well, the short film. I'm a little scared. I'm a little nervous. Watch my reaction video to see how I feel about All Too Well, the 10-minute version. I'll be discussing it more at length on my podcast, The Evolution of a Snake, with my wonderful co-host, Madeline. But you know, we're just gonna like watch this together, see how it feels. I don't know what to think. I'm confused because apparently it's running in theaters for a week. So she's trying to get an Oscar for this, which makes sense because she's not gonna get one by acting. All right, so I guess we'll just start. I'm so frightened. Love is so short, forgetting is so long. The quote that she put in the red album booklet. Oh my God, this is gonna fuck me up, isn't it?
Are you for real?
Dylan really be looking like Jake in this. This ginger girl should have ringlets. Very pretty, shot on 35mm, okay. Not bad.
I walked to the door with you. The air was cold.
Dylan looks creepy, huh? She looks how she did in those candids where they're walking down the street. Fabled scarf. And it's the one you can buy for sale on her website, of course. An upstate escape. I need to clean my glasses for this. I wonder if this is like a recreation of what happened from Taylor's mind or something completely different. They're really getting into it in the forest, huh? Ew. First crack in the glass. The red lip and the black turtleneck, okay, Easter eggs. So basically, he's being a cunt and treating her like a child in front of his friends. Giving young Taylor energy, this girl. Jake seems like the kind of guy that has a temper. He's using an iPhone 4, wow, okay.
Why are you so pissed off?
I'm not pissed off, I said I was pissed off.
Because you're acting to stop. Ridiculous.
Gaslighting.
It's my friends.
Okay.
They were super fucking nice to you, too.
No, I liked your friends. I never said I didn't like your friends. I didn't like the way that you acted around them.
You were being weird and quiet the entire time.
It's not being weird because you weren't looking at me. You didn't ask me one thing the entire night.
That's such bullshit. That's such bullshit.
You dropped my fucking hand. What am I supposed to do with that?
I didn't even fucking notice. What are you talking
about? I don't know any of these people. They're all
Taylor's
strangers.
The kind of person that would remember that.
Well, like, what are you talking
about? I feel so out of place. You're the only one
that
can
about
you.
I'm catching up with friends. You're literally saying I dropped your hand. Like, I don't even remember the moment that you're talking about. How can you be, like, attacking me about something I don't even, like, fucking know? I was doing it subconsciously. I was catching up with
you. Don't, you're making me feel fucking stupid.
Holy shit. I don't think I'm making you feel that way. I think you're making yourself feel that way.
What?
Literally a moment that
a
I don't
dickhead.
Even fucking remember. That you're, like, fucking, like, holding me hostage over. It's insane.
Literally
it's fucking crazy. These people I haven't seen in, like, 10 years. And you just sit there the entire fucking time.
And that's her problem.
It was fun. I actually had a fucking blast. Now this is the night. Now we're doing this. Awesome. So fucking awesome.
You just treated me differently.
What do you mean I treated you differently? catching up with my friends.
Trust me, they were enthralled by you, of course.
I'm sorry, you're making me really make the entire night about you.
Look at me.
Holy shit, I can't.
It's fucking selfish. It's really like, it's so crazy.
Oh, so you're selfish now.
Yes,
selfish
you're making
now.
About, you're acting selfish. See, you're acting selfish, absolutely. Right now, that's exactly what's happening. Don't fucking look at me like that. That's so fucked up.
This is how scary manipulative people badger you. Like, this argument is very triggering. He's being awful.
Hey, come on.
Is this where they're dancing?
I'm sorry. It's alright, drop your hand. Come on.
The acting is really good.
Come on. Sorry.
And I know it's long gone.
Wow.
There was nothing else I could do. And I forget about you long enough to forget who I needed to.
Are you real? What does that mean? This is giving very intense, short-term codependency vibe to me. The breaking point. Ah! This is what I want to know. What happened? God, she's just searching for a reason. I literally hate Taylor being heartbroken. Oh no! No! Death to anyone who upsets Taylor Swift. Why? Oh, is she writing a letter? Writing on a typewriter is like absolutely something she would do. That guy's not old enough to look like anyone's dad in this video. The famous 21st birthday. I know for a fact she was doing karaoke, so this is a historically inaccurate detail for her 21st birthday. God, she's just in an unmade bed, books and clothes piled up. Like, I'm putting bounty out on Jake Gyllenhaal's neck. White Horse music video parallels. Sitting there, crying in the dark. This girl is a great actress. I really like their pairing. It's a very artistic interpretation of Taylor and Jake. Oh, the wind in her hair! I can. I'm gonna put a hex on this man. Book. So she's written a book about what happened to her. Is it Taylor in a red wig again? I love Taylor in a red wig. It is. Oh my god, she looks amazing. This is so bizarre. Like, she looks like a different person. She, for sure, is an author in an alternate life. Oh my god, and he's watching from the window as she's giving her talk. Ah! Wearing the scarf? Okay. Alright. It's just a little bit iconic. From now on? Okay. What to even say? Like, where do I begin? I feel like I was just waterboarded. Okay, the cinematography is gorgeous. The shots are really beautiful. Upstate New York in autumn. I mean, you can't get more romantic and doomed than that. So beautiful. I love the imagery. I thought that there was a very good artistic reinterpretation of events. So the ending kind of reveals that this is not supposed to be a play-by-play, but there are definitely, I can see, moments that are drawn from real life. Her attention to detail, as usual, is wonderful. The phones, the old phones, the sharing the headphones that have a wire, the scarf, obviously that's available for purchase on her website because she's a shrewd capitalist. I mean, I don't know what I was expecting from her appearance in this, but I certainly was not expecting her in a ginger wig with ginger eyebrows. Now that was a surprise. And may I just say, she looked beautiful. Like that, her coloring really suits that hairstyle. I thought that she looked, the 13 years later thing has like really shaken me to my very core. Dylan O'Brien did an excellent job of portraying a disturbed, fucked up, horrible, terrible human being. So props to him for acting. I presume that he's a nicer person in real life. Sadie Sink, I believe is her name. She was incredible. I really thought that her performance really captured Taylor's like, youthful exuberance, but also her naivety. It seems as though like, you know, in the fight scene and all of that, like I never really, I guess, pictured Taylor in any of her relationships giving it back, like fighting and getting angry. I don't know why. I just don't picture it, but it's for sure one of those moments. And I'm a little shook by it. I'm shaken up. I'm scared. Yeah, I guess the interpretation of events is Taylor's version of things, plus whatever fictionalization elements she's added in. I love the idea of, in an alternate universe, Taylor being a writer and writing a book about an experience like this, because that is 100% what she would be doing if she's not a musician. But I'm like very pleasantly surprised and excited by this. This makes the 10-minute version so much better to me. So I loved that. I really want a signed copy of the movie poster. So if anyone wants to hook me the fuck up, let me know. That's it for this video. I will see you in my next one, which will be reacting to this being performed on SNL. So I hope that you all have a wonderful, magical Red release weekend, and I will see you soon.